apart fairly quickly. So after about 10 years, these buildings would have been levelled and another buildings built on top. We're lucky to find these remains, because the Romans didn't do a particularly good job in demolishing these buildings before they put the next ones on top of them. What's ongoing at the moment, and you've got to remember that when we're digging down at these buildings, we're going down to the clay floors in them buildings. They didn't have stone floors, and that's brilliant. The Romans have done us tremendous favours here, because the floors, what they did was had a clay floor, and they would just put bracken and moss and straw on the top to provide some sort of floor. But the rascals were lazy, and they didn't take out the old floor, the old straw, when it became horrible. They just put new on top. So any coins, any bits of jewellery, any writing tablets, yeah, and any other things that fell into the floor and they couldn't be bothered to find them, were left for us to dig out many years later. The archaeologists call these floors laminate floors. Well, I've got a laminate floor at home and it ain't made of straw. There's nothing new, is there? These archaeologists have got their own language and I've got to learn it pretty quick. But they're over the moon that the Romans had this sort of lazy attitude. And they're over the moon that the Romans would cut everything off at the base, fill all the ditches in with what was left, and then put turf and mud on top of it and seal it from everything, from the oxygen. We've gone back on this site and dug out these amazing writing tablets. Some 1600. Most of them were found in that corner where you can see the big ditch there. Yeah. And there's evidence that we found a load of them in one particular spot that the Romans had tried to burn. They tried to destroy them, but there must have been a downpour of rain on that day and put the fire out, luckily. And the gods had been with us, yeah? And they hadn't been bothered, they couldn't light it again. 2,000 years later, nearly, we found them. We know the names of who was the officer in charge here, one Flavius Perialis. We know his wife, Sulpicia Lepidina, strange name. We know for a fact that she was invited to a birthday party by her friend who was billeted in Corbridge, and she would love to come to the birthday party, and that was found in a writing tablet. We know for a fact that when the Tongrians were here, one particular day, the writing tablet gives us the disposition of the troops, where they all were, and there wasn't 1,000 here. There was something like 700. There were several down in York, helping out down there. There was 20-odd down in Corbridge on leave. That was the Newcastle of the day, yeah. There was 6 in the sick bay. These people up in the sick bay had conjunctivitis. We know they had an eye infection. But, you know, nothing's changed. And that came out of the writing tablet.